And then Asa Hutchinson, 733. The question is, who's going to be left in 1 month in September, and who will it benefit if that's a smaller stage? I talked to Governor DeSantis this morning. He said he would love a smaller stage. He said it was kind of shocking how much some of the other candidates seem to really dislike Vivek. And that's where a lot of the ire went to. Headlines in the New York Times, Vivek comes in hot, steals the spotlight. Washington Chapman, Republican debate, Nikki Haley wins and it's not particularly close. USA Today, on Trumpless debate, Ramaswamy Haley made themselves heard. Also getting good reviews is Ron DeSantis. They're with us right now. A woman that was kind enough to come down and preview this whole thing on Fox and Friends yesterday, and now joins us on the radio today. Erin Perini, communications director of Never Back Down, super back supporting Ron DeSantis. And Erin, I'm so jealous because tonight you're going to be in the Field of Dreams and you're going to be doing a fundraiser with the governor of Florida. Why was I not invited?
That's my fault, Brian. I'm really sorry about that. Next time we will make
sure that
happens. I know. It's my biggest regret of the morning. But yeah, we have Governor Ron DeSantis coming as a special guest at the Field of Dreams. You know, a lot of people, you heard a little bit of this when it told me last day, they know the name, but they don't know the man. They don't know that he played college baseball and that he was the captain of a baseball team at Yale and that he worked through college to be able to afford college and law school and then go serve in the Navy as a Jedi attorney. So we're really excited to have the governor tonight. The Field of Dreams is absolutely iconic, and as we've been crisscrossing Iowa with him as a special guest, he always talks about how him and Mason will be playing baseball and throwing the ball around, and Mason always asks, is this heaven? And the governor says, no, it's Iowa, and we are so excited for that.
Right, so I would say this about half the counties, maybe a little bit more he wants to go through. He had mentioned to me, too, that President Trump's only been there twice and has kind of had war with the governor. Why is there such a gap if there seems to be two different approaches to a state that matters so much? Donald Trump, I think, has about a 20-point lead, I think 41-19.
Well, I think that this speaks to the old adage that you don't shop for Christmas trees in August. Right now, it's about new idea and who's driving the early media conversation. Who are people seeing the most in their newspapers and on their TV? And because of four indictments, right now that's Donald Trump. So when people start to dominate around Christmas time, especially in Iowa, and you're looking at this early voting space, if you look at the recent Vermont register poll, 61% of likely caucus voters are considering Governor Ron DeSantis, and he has the highest favorability rate of any candidate in Iowa. So he's putting in the work. He's going to do the full draft, like a full 99 counties. He's going to shake hands because you can't accept this nomination to be given to you. It has to be earned. You saw that Buckner man last night, talked with the governor on the debate stage, and you're going to feel that he's on going through Iowa to make sure our caucus night, that people know that they want America to get back on the right track. We're going to have a strong economic plan, military plan, a plan for our children and their education. It's Governor Ron DeSantis.
So here's what the governor said last night about this feud, alleged feud, with Donald Trump. He said this to Sean Hannity, it's not fair.
I support him. I support him in 16, obviously. And then in 2020, they really relied on me, you know, to do a lot in Florida. I raised more money than him, than any elected official in the country. I mean, I raised, you know, $10, $15 million. And we worked really hard to make sure the Florida election ran really well. You know, we have the best election integrity in the country.
So, and he went back and forth on that. So what is the right tactic? How do you think the governor is handling his rivalry with the president?
I think the governor is handling this absolutely correctly, because if he talks about what is happening in this country,